Standard 10th, Lesson 8, Natural Resources. Good morning, everyone. Children, we are going to study about natural resources. Now, humans are satisfied partially or completely only through resources. There are thousands of elements in the nature, but we cannot call them all resources. These elements can only be called resources when they are utilized by man with his knowledge and expertise. We are dependent, that means all the humans are dependent on these resources to fulfill them. Physically and intellectual capacity to utilize them, and that is why they are called as resources. The next is, today we are extremely useful due to this utility and developed techniques of mining. The natural resources could have both the virtues of utility and capability to work. Now, the resources which we are talking about is having an interaction with three: nature, man and culture. Uses of resources, they are used in many ways. You are getting them from agriculture, from industry, and that is why there are different types. Very important is resources as food. We cannot stay without food, children, as you all know. And everything, whatever we are getting it, you are getting it from nature. So food is one of the resource. That is how you are getting the food, from crops, agriculture, animals. Like animals, you are getting milk, meat and other things, fish. Because aquatic animals are also giving us the honey is prepared by honeybees, that is in the forest, of course. So this is all about the resources as food. The next one is resource as a source of raw material. Now, raw material means these raw materials are used in the industries and then you are getting the finished products. But what is raw material? From where you are getting it? You are getting it from the forest, from the agriculture, from animals. So from the forest, you are getting herbs, wood and many other things. And from agriculture, crops and many more things which we are going to study later in the next lessons. Mineral ores. These are the resource which is used in the industries. Next is energy. Now, what energy? Coal, petroleum, natural gas. A car cannot move without petrol. The fuel in the industries as well as in the domestic fuel. You cannot cook food without the fuel which you are using it at home, LG, gas. Then the another energy, very important, the solar, isolation, wind, sea waves, tides, ebbs, waterfalls, they are all energy which we are using it. Now we'll see the types of resources. They are classified into three parts: basis of ownership, basis of reavailability and basis of distribution center. Now, individual resources, that is owned by a family or individual, which is land and building, because a building is owned by someone, a land is owned by someone, that is an individual. Next is a country or a region, the whole. Suppose you imagine your map of India, how can you say that? It's a national resource, army, international trade and many other things. Global resource, all the physical and non-physical resources which are used by human welfare. Ownership of all nations of the world, resources of common ownership which is being used by the world globally. Now we'll see the classification on the basis of distribution. Distribution means universal, useful gases in the atmosphere. This is used by everyone. Oxygen, nitrogen and many other. General available resources, which is easily available. Land, soil, water, pasture land. Rare resources, which are limited. Minerals, copper, gold, uranium, petrol, coal, etc. Solitary, that is only available in one or two places in the world. granolite, which is available only in Greenland. Now children, you have understood about the classification. Now they are again classified into two, renewable and non-renewable resources. Specific, now non-renewable resources. Some resources reproduce themselves as per their usage during a specific time. These are inexhaustible. Solar insolation, wind, birds, animals, bioreserves, etc. They comes in this category. They are called renewable resources. And non-renewable resources which cannot be reused and they cannot be even reproduced, and they are natural gas, petroleum, etc., which are included in this category. We have to plan because things are getting over by and then. So human needs are unlimited and resources are limited. This is very important. You have to underline this and then only you will be able to understand. During last 100 years of age, the resources has been increased very much due to extraordinary development in science and technology. As you all know children, the stage which we are living now, the things which is going around, the science, the technology, and also the population explosion. So we are using extraordinarily the resources. So definitely the day will come, they are going to be reduced. So it is our first duty to conserve them for our future generation. We don't have to be so selfish, only thinking about us. You have to conserve them and use them rationally. So conservation is directly related to the scarcity of resources, because they are definitely going to be scarce, because we have already overused them and still we are using them. So they are going to be getting over very soon. So we have to take care of these resources. That means conservation and reuse, which will help us to put them into proper place and future generation can also use them. Now, planning and conservation. First of all, gather all the availability of utilized and probable resources of any country as a unit. That means you should know what is the resources in a particular country and how it has to be used properly, rationally. Next point is the resources which are limited or non-renewable, they should be exploited scientifically and should be used only when they are necessary, not to be used haphazardly. Attempts should be made to develop those resources, the quantity of which can be increased. Try to use and develop those resources where the quantity can be increased. The resources which are cheaper and are easily available should not be wasted, but instead should be used sparingly for future. It doesn't mean that the resources which are available cheaper or you are getting it very easily should not be used again haphazardly. They should be used properly. Those resources which are limited quantity should be conserved, finding its alternative option through technical development, because we are developing, as we all know, technically. So these resources which are in limited quantity should be conserved, should be used properly. Necessary laws are formed in that the conservation of resources should be enforced strictly. The laws, who makes the law? Government. Who follows the law? We citizens. So we have to follow necessarily the laws which is made by the government to take proper care of our resources. And if we are doing that, that means we are conserving them and we are thinking for the future generation. Citizens should be well acquainted with all facts associated with the rational usage of resources, and a public awareness should be cultivated.